Welcome back to our Drupal tutorial series. In this video, we will explore how to add custom validations to a content type fields in a Drupal. As you know, custom validations is essential for ensuring data integrity and user experience on your Drupal website. Whether it's validating user inputs or enforcing specific rules for content types, Drupal gives us flexibility to tailor validation to our needs. In this video, I will show you how to add custom validations to the content type field using the hook form alter. I had already created a detailed video about what is hook form alter. That video link I will add in this description. So we'll explain a bit about the hook form alter. Hook underscore form underscore alter. This hooks allows us to modify form structure in a Drupal. It's incredibly powerful and serves as the backbone for any customization. Please watch this video till the end. I will show you the drawbacks of using hook form alter for adding the validations to the content type field and in which scenario you should use the hook form alter and when not to use hook form alter. Also, I will explain the alternate method to add the validations to the content type fields. Now, let's get into the juicy part, adding custom validations to content type fields in a Drupal. For this tutorial, let's say we have a content type called employee and we want to enforce a minimum character limit for the name field. Now, let's go to the backend of our Drupal and go to the structure, click on content types. In content types, here you can see the employee content type. I will show you the fields which are available in this employee content type. For that, click on manage fields. In this content type, I have added three fields, email address, name and the salary. For this tutorial, we will focus on this name field. As you know, the Drupal provides some basic validations like the required. So you can add those required validation by selecting this checkbox. But we will set the custom validation on name field like it should contain the minimum 5 characters. Now let's head over to our custom module. If you don't have created one yet, now is the time. So I had created this custom user info, my custom module. In this module, we will implement the hook form alter to target the employee content type fields. So to add the hook form alter, go to the .module file of your module. In this .module file, we will add our hook form alter function. So first, I will add the comment. Implements hook form alter. Now we will write our hook form alter function. Here you need to replace this hook with your module name. So my module name is custom underscore user underscore info. Custom underscore user underscore info. After that, write the hook name, that is the form underscore alter. In the parameters, we need to add the three parameters, that is ampersand dollar form, second is Drupal core form and form state interface. Form underscore state. And third is the dollar form ID. So first we will check form ID. If dollar form ID is equal to, so we are adding the custom validations on the employee content type. So to get this content types form ID, for that go to the content, click on add content and click on this employee content type. After that click on this inspect elements, and in the form tag check the form ID. So here you can see the ID of this form is node-employee-form. So copy this. So this will be the form ID of our employee content type, and we need to replace this hyphen with the underscore. So here we are checking the form ID. If the form ID is of the employee content type, then we will write the form, and inside the square bracket we'll check validate empty square bracket equal to, we will add one callback function. So I will give the callback function name as a custom user info. So this is the name of my custom module. After that we are going to add the validation on the employee content type form. So we'll add the employee form, and at the end we need to add the validate. Now create this callback function outside our hook form alter. So create the function and name of the callback function. Again it will accept the two parameters. First is $form, and second is $form state, $form underscore state. Now in this callback function we will first get the value of our name field, this field. So here you can see the machine name or this field name is field underscore name. On the submit of this form we will get the value in this callback function. So for that we will get one variable form underscore value and get the value of that content type name field $form underscore state, get value, and name of the field or field name is field underscore name. After that zero index of array and the value. So in this variable we will get the data which we have entered in the name field. Here we will add our custom validations. We will add the validations like the name should field should contain the characters more than 5. For that if strlen, so this is the PHP function to check the length of our string, and we'll pass this form underscore value variable less than 5, then we will show the error message. We will show the error message like this, $form underscore state set error by name, and pass the machine name of our field, field underscore name, comma, and in the t function add the message name field should contain more than 5 characters. So in this way we have created our hook, and we have checked if the fields contains the more than 5 characters. If it contains the less than 5 character, it should show this error message. Save this file and clear the cache. I will clear the cache using the drush command. That is the drush here. The cache is cleared successfully. Now go to backend and try to add the new content in the employee content type. For that I will refresh this content type. Add the title and the name field. We will add the 3 characters only. And the email address, I will add email address. And in salary, I will add the salary. And click on the save. So it should show the error message for this name field. Name field should contains more than 5 characters. And we have added the 3 characters. So we have set this error message here. Name field should contain the more than 5 characters. And we have successfully set the custom validations to the content type field using the hook form alter. Now I will add more than 5 characters. I will try to save this form again. So the form is submitted successfully. Again, if you want to add the same validations on the edit of this content type, you can add the edit form ID in our condition. Like I will show you that as well. So our form name is node employee edit form. Here again add the condition or dollar form underscore ID equal to node underscore employee underscore edit underscore form, because we need to replace the hyphen with the underscore. I will not save this. Before that, I will show you in the edit section. I will change the name field's length to 3 characters only. I will save it. So the in the edit form, it accepted 3 characters. Now I will save this form and again I will try to edit that node with these 3 characters only. So it should show the error message in the edit section as well. Now I will explain you when to use the hook form alter and when not. Suppose if you are having the form like this, then you can use the hook form alter. And you have created any REST API for this content type and which creates the node using that API. So in that case, the custom validations will won't work. So I will show you by example. I have this API which creates the node in employee content type. Now I will create the new node using this API. I will add title as employee ABC details. In the type target ID, we add the name of our content type. So my content type name is employee. And in the title, I will add the title as employee ABC details. In name field, I will set the name as ABC and will try to create the node. For that, click on send. So here you can see the new node is created with this detail, title employee ABC, and in the name field we have passed just 3 characters, but we have set the validations using the hook form alter. So in this case, those validations are not working. I will show you this node as well. Go to the content. Here you can see the newly created node in the employee content type. Click on this edit. Here you can see it has accepted the 3 characters name. To avoid this type of scenarios, we need to use the constant validations in a Drupal. I will explain you how to add validations using the constraint to the content type fields in a Drupal. So that's it from this video. I hope this video is useful for you. Please like the video and subscribe our channel for more Drupal related content. Thank you for watching and see you in the next tutorial.